we're going around doing some interviews. And we're asking people, what do they think makes something morally right or wrong? You guys have any thoughts on that?
Can I answer?
We'll let Drew answer.
All right, Drew, you're up.
Ask the question one more time.
What makes something morally right or wrong? Like, why is murder wrong? Stealing? Things like that. Like, what makes that wrong?
Well, we three believe in the Bible, and so it's obviously one of the Ten Commandments, and not to make it right. So
you go to the Bible, that's the standard for everyone. That's what makes something morally right or wrong.
Yeah.
Everyone, everywhere, all the time.
Yeah.
Okay.
I just think we're here to not kill each other, but we're here to work together.
Right. So, okay, you're Christians, and we are as well.
Yeah.
So, if you had to share the gospel, say I got a man to live or something, I didn't know anything about Christianity, what would you tell me?
I would just start at Genesis. You look at where he started the creation, and just go to the Ten Commandments, get that, and then, give a couple of stories of how God has showed his ways and how he's faithful to us. And with that, you would just see the points that are placed out in the Bible.
Okay, how do I have peace with God? Like, specifically.
Yeah. And how do you what?
How do I have peace with God?
Peace with
praying
God.
Is a big thing.
Yeah,
just praying.
Yeah, prayer, meditation through the Word.
Being in his Word.
Okay, why don't I just believe in Allah then and pray to him and meditate towards that direction? Why is the Christian God the way to go?
Because he was the only one to die for our sins on the cross. None of the other gods did that.
Okay, this person, I know nothing about Christianity at all. I've lived in a bubble my whole life. I know absolutely nothing. You have to explain to me, who is this Jesus guy you're talking about who died? And why in the world does that make me have peace with God? Because some dude 2,000 years ago died on a tree.
I tell them a story from the Bible, and then also explain to him that he never did any wrong, and he never told anybody anything wrong, and so there's basically no reason to not believe the Bible and not believe the guy who's protesting it. Through Old and New Testament.
Yeah. So is he just a man?
No. He's half God, half man.
Not half God.
No, fully God.
There you go.
Yeah. That's what I said. Yeah, my bad.
No, that's
all right.
No,
I know we're testing
y'all. Yeah, I mean, that's what I should encourage you guys. We're Christians. You know, with all that's going on right now, you know, we need to be grounded in what the Bible says. Because you're right. What makes something morally wrong is what the Bible says. And most of the people we talk to don't get that answer. So 1 Peter 3:15 says that all believers need to be ready to make a defense for the hope within us, right? So if we really believe that the people we're walking by, if they don't trust in Christ and repent, the God man, and in him alone, that they're going to hell for eternity, you know, would it not be hateful for us not to tell them, not to be ready to tell them? So the challenge of the apostles and Christ were to know what the Bible says so that you can tell others the same thing. I'd encourage you to get the scriptures, to know the scriptures, and to be ready to tell others as well. In this time, especially,
yeah,
we need to be grounded.